I was so excited to see the yellow dress again.
It was like really once in a lifetime. That was so special.
Hello, fashion.
What is your favorite season?
Awards.
Hi. Today I want to talk to you about awards seasons. Over the time when we were at home, I really missed fancy dresses and diamonds and the stress and the travel associated with awards. And I wanted to show you some of my very favorite moments and talk to you about how they came to be. So by the time we get to awards, I really start from what's worked. I look at pictures and I think, color works, this shape works, this designer is really a good fit for her. They get along, they speak the same language. And then from there, I get lots of sketches, often from lots of designers, and they come with color cards or fabric swatches, embroidery swatches, and usually we kind of spread them out and choose. I edit them down first, usually. Making a dress is a few steps. Often the fabrics that we're working with are so expensive or they're embroidered. So first you make a toile in like a cotton or something that you can draw on, mark up, write on it, pin it wherever you want, cut it with scissors. Usually we have three fittings where we try it on again and again and make sure everything is perfect. I really don't like to rely on things like tape. I really like the tailoring to be exceptional. I am so lucky to work with people who I really respect, who have so much skill and talent. That's you, Joelle. After we decide the dress, then I pick the jewelry, and finally we start talking to the hair and makeup team. We usually show some reference pictures that are the inspiration for the design, and we usually just start a text chain. What are you thinking with this? What are you thinking with this? And finally we get to the day. I like things to be as relaxed as possible. We try really hard to be calm and have good, fun vibes and get them out the door to the show. So I called in three of my very favorites, three dresses that I hadn't seen in a while that I was really excited to revisit. It's a little bit like seeing old friends, and there were details I didn't remember, so I hope you like it. Here we have the Michelle Williams yellow dress. I had just started working with Michelle Williams that year. She was the star of Brokeback Mountain with Heath Ledger. They were both nominated for Oscars. I immediately thought of Vera Wang. She's someone I've worked with multiple times in the past. She has the best tailor in the world, Suhaila. So I called Vera and she was like, yes, I love it, let's do it. This yellow color, I feel like now it's part of our sort of fashion vernacular. We see this a lot, but at the time nobody was really wearing yellow. And I just had a gut instinct. I mean, so much of what I do is just sort of these moments that are usually not when I'm in the office, they're in the middle of the night, or they're like when I'm chopping an onion, making dinner. And I think, oh, it needs to be the color of an egg yolk. I think it'll have an impact. Michelle was like, yes, that's exactly what I want. It was super unusual at the time. It made the whole thing feel less fussy. It made it feel young and cool and surprising. And this neckline, I think, is one of the most flattering that there is for a woman because it elongates the neck and it shows the décolleté. This pleated tulle detail sort of adds a little bit of romance and poetry, that magic that a fancy dress can have. I think that the armpit and the skin of the armpit is one of the most unappealing parts of the body. So I love that this sort of delicately disguises that part of the body. I had totally forgotten that this was a raw edge, sort of matte silk dress. And you know, it reminds me very much of that era of Albero Baz at Lanvin and deconstructed dressing. Instead of being just a simple slip shape, it has this draping along the hip. It gives a little bit of a 40s feeling, but it also really wraps the body and creates the fanciness without being too much. It's not a belt, it's not rhinestones or pleating. It's like a really elegant shaping drape. Then in the back, there's a godet. It has like this light tulle romantic layer that gives you an idea of a train, and it has the same pleated tulle detail sort of outlining the godet. There's a hoop so that she could carry it on her hand, and she was out at the parties. So that I thought was really fabulous. There's a picture of them together and she's got it in her hand and you see it and it just looks really, really beautiful.
Hi. I was so excited to see the yellow dress again. Thanks for loaning it to me.
Oh my gosh, of course. I'm so glad that it's out of its bag and into some hands.
You got ready in that suite in the chateau.
It was like really once in a lifetime. That was so special.
I feel like one of the things that really made that dress too was the hair and makeup, like the red lip. Yeah. And you had that like that little like side.
Yeah. Kara had wanted to do like a brick maroon, like vamp. And you were like, no. Red. She was like, vamp, and you're like, it's gonna be red, and I thought it was red.
But you know what, we talked afterwards because I felt like I was kind of pushy that day, and she was like, you were right, I'm so sorry, I was sweating.
No, you were totally right. No, it was like a fun like creative conversation that you were just like, you know, you've been living with that dress for so long too, and like had spent so much time thinking about it and perfecting it, and like, you knew.
I had kind of forgotten that it had raw edges. Like, when I pulled it out, I was like, oh, this is so of its time.
Yeah, I was just going to say, would you make the same choice now? Like, maybe not.
No. Like, we never leave a raw edge like that.
That's so interesting, because the dress also feels, like, incredibly timeless, but it's that small detail that actually kind of dates it in place, which is actually really special.
Yeah, really nice.
Yeah, I love that dress.
Me too. Bye.
Okay, bye.
This episode was not sponsored by McDonald's, despite the color scheme. So this is a dress that Selena Gomez wore to the AMAs in 2016. This dress was really exciting because Selena was reaching a new place in her life. She wanted to be a strong woman. And I felt like this dress really showed that. It showed sort of power and class and elegance. And she gave a really moving speech in it that brought me to tears.
If you are broken, you do not have to stay broken. And if that's anything, whether you respect me or not, that's one thing you should know about me, is I care about people, and thank you so much for this. This is for you. Thank you.
I felt really proud that I was able to sort of provide her armor for that moment. This dress is by Prada, and it was a custom dress. It's quite simple. The neckline is ever so slightly square. I love how the straps get quite small at the top, and it really sort of frames and showcases the clavicle. Although it looks quite simple, inside it's quite complex, and you can see that it's darted all through here to really show off her waist. And then it's super full at the bottom with a slight train. It's like a matte organza, which is funny because in photos it often looks shiny, but in fact it's matte and it has a really dry touch. And then it has another layer of red organza. The sort of secret magic of this dress is that there's this beautiful yellow underskirt. So it's layer upon layer of like a pale lemon tulle. It's romantic and it looks so cute if you're just wearing this skirt and a little bra. I love it when there's something hidden or something private that makes you feel beautiful or strong or like you have a secret. One thing I thought was interesting too is this detail on the back. It's sort of masculine and fun and a little bit 60s. There are two buttons and a little belt, and that also did help cinch the waist a tiny bit. Okay. This is a dress from Chanel Couture that Margot Robbie wore to the Oscars in 2018 when she was nominated for I, Tonya. It was inspired by a dress that Carl had shown years before that was in another color and another silhouette, but there were elements from that dress that we thought were super beautiful and would really work for Margot. So we sent that photo and said, this is an inspiration, what do you think? And this was the design in the end. It is a very, very white, and I won't touch it too much, matte silk. And the dress is actually quite complex. It has seams that are horizontal all along the bust. It's almost like a tulip, sort of opening this way. It has a series of different petals, layers that go to the bottom. Oh, we get wind from outside too to show you how it moves. I really love this embroidery. It's super three-dimensional. It's got rhinestones that are sort of princess cut diamond shape. It has sort of box beading with these baguettes that are really incredible. And then tiny, tiny little rhinestone beads. There are classic Chanel camellias right here, which kind of get lost a little bit you know, you don't see the detail so well. And there's this raw edge tulle. Chanel owns their embroidery house, and they're so masterful. It kind of hangs like jewelry on the dress instead of being attached, just sort of like some simple crystals sewn on. It's almost as if they made a necklace that could drape around the shoulders and the bust. This dress also has one of my favorite features, which is that little bit that covers that armpit. If there's a way to cover it, I will. Originally, the dress ended at this level, and you could see her feet. And we were really excited about that. We thought that it would be super elegant and interesting and a departure from, you know, your traditional Oscar ball gown. But once we fit the dress, we realized that in a picture, it didn't have this like elongated silhouette, which is so beautiful in a gown. And you ended up kind of zooming in on her feet. The solution was to add another layer underneath so that she becomes just a white column. That kind of thing is one of the most fun parts of my job. I love collaborating with a designer and seeing where their mind goes, and then working out the kinks, how to make the image something that'll really resonate, and figuring out the architecture of a dress, how you make this dress look the best in a photo that's possible. It's quite different, something that you would want to wear just to a party and what you want to have a million photos taken and zoomed around the world. You need to make sure that every detail is correct, and that the dress is doing everything for the woman and working in every way on her body to make her sort of the most beautiful and strong representation of who she is in that moment. I hope you enjoyed visiting with these dresses as much as I did. If you have any ideas for shows or questions you'd like me to answer, please leave them in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell and follow me at Kate Young.